Hey, good morning, everybody. How y'all doing? This your boy, Rob Thomas Jr., and this is Briefly the Real News Behind the News. Today is October 7th, 2019. And I'm going to be real brief in this video because I know myself and everybody else is getting ready to go out there and make that day to try to provide for our kids. But I'm going to ask a serious question. Now, first of all, y'all know I'm not a supporter of Donald Trump, but I do support the truth. And what I want to get y'all to understand is if you keep watching that television, watching the news on the television, you all are going to be some of the most deceived people on the face of the planet. Now, let's talk about this. Syria. Let me ask y'all a question. Who actually started that whole war in Syria? Who started that war in Yemen? Black people are going to be mad when I tell y'all the truth, but it was Barack Obama, who actually started the war in Syria. It was a destabilization plan. If y'all don't know what that word means, go back and understand the word destabilization. They were basically trying to get Syria destabilized, overthrown, so they could put in a puppet ruler in place of Bashar al-Assad to basically control the oil flow in Syria for your American oil companies. Negroes are sitting around here looking at the news talking about Donald Trump shouldn't pull out of Syria. First of all, do you realize that America is in Syria illegally? We have no business, no right, no legal authority to be in Syria in the first place. So when Trump, who again, I am not a Trump supporter, but when Trump telling y'all that we are pulling out of Syria, why y'all getting mad? Why aren't y'all mad that we over there in the first place illegally putting our soldiers in harm's way, but most importantly, killing all those innocent Syrian civilians? It's obvious that y'all have not been watching over the last, 5 years, what the United States has illegally been doing over there in Syria, killing all these innocent people, basically by backing ISIS or ISIL or all these other groups. You see what I'm saying? Now Trump saying we're going to pull out of Syria, and his stupid ass talking about it and all his wisdom and all that, he's going to let Turkey go over there. First of all, how the hell are you going to tell the Turks that they can go illegally into the country of Syria? So we're sitting here, man, and I'm sitting back watching all this stuff go down and how Americans, black and white, are divided on the issue. Should we stay or should we go? And nobody is saying that we should have never been there in the first place. The United States is illegally occupying. They are occupiers, just like the Israelis are occupiers of Palestine, of Israel. They are occupying force. So the Syrian government has the right, the legal right, to do whatever they want. But the only reason why they haven't responded is because they know if they respond and strike the United States servicemen that's over there, it's going to draw the whole military force of the United States in their country, but we're there illegally. So, man, my whole thing about this is stop believing what you see on that TV without doing research. Because once you do research behind what they show you on that TV, you're going to realize everything on that TV that they're showing you is bull crap. It's a lie. It is propaganda at its finest. It is the brainwashing of the American people. Because for you all to sit up here and even have any kind of doubts, debates, or feelings about the United States being in Syria and Donald Trump saying we finna pull out, if you all got any doubts, debates, or questions about that, that lets me know that you are not aware. Because first of all, we have no legal right under international law, under our law, to be in Syria. But did you know only Congress is really supposed to be able to declare war? But how is it that Bush Obama and Trump was able to start all these new wars. I'm talking about Iraq, Afghanistan, Syria, Yemen, Libya. All these wars. And another war that y'all forgot about that Clinton started, which is Somalia. Nobody's talking about Somalia, but guess what? They're trying to say that Afghanistan is the longest war that we've ever been in. Now, that's bullshit. They've been in Somalia for 28 years. Nobody talks about that because it's an African country. We do whatever fuck we want to do in Africa. This is what your United States government thinks about. But for all you Negroes sitting around here, man, Negroes and white people here in America, sitting up here debating the issue, should Trump pull out of Syria? If you all are not saying we should have never been in Syria in the first place, then that lets me know you have no clue as to what's really going on in geopolitics. We like to think that we know what's going on in politics, but a lot of us don't even research it. We just hear what's going on the TV, and then we start talking those same talking points on Facebook and other social medias without having a clue as to what the real deal is. Barack Obama started the war in Syria in 2014, illegally trying to overthrow Al-Assad's government. Assad's government. So that American oil companies could take over the oil in Syria. Now, let me show you how that one area of Syria that they talking about that we still holding on to, and everybody is mad because Donald Trump is pulling the troops from that area. You want to know what that area in Syria is? That's one of Syria's biggest oil producing regions in that country. Man, y'all better understand, man, that if you keep watching this TV, you're going to be blind in one eye and can't see out the other. Because that's what the television is controlled and designed by your military industrial complex. Guess what? Guess when you look at the sponsors of your news, whether it be Fox, MSNBC, CNN, ABC, CBS, no matter what it is, guess who controls your message, the message that's coming out from that TV? Your military industrial complex, your pharmaceutical industrial complex. You know what I'm saying? These are the people that pay your media to lie to you. But guess what? As long as you follow the real news behind the news, you're going to always get the truth. We should never been in Syria in the first place. What it was, after that false flag 9/11, George Bush created what's called the War Powers Act, which allowed them to say that wherever ISIS is on the planet, we're going to go over there and destroy ISIS. So guess what that means? If ISIS is found to be on the Cooper Road, Lakeside, Allendale, Cedar Grove, that means your military has the right under the War Powers Act to come in to Lakeside, Allendale, Cooper Road, and Cedar Grove and fight ISIS, which means thousands of innocent people going to get killed. This is the game, man. All this shit is a game, man. And we are losing the game as black people because we are sitting up here watching what these people on the TV tell us, which is propaganda, nothing more than propaganda, and it's brainwashing you and dictating how you think. And when you think, you're thinking along illogical lines because you have not researched the problem that they're telling you about. Because once you research the problem, you'll find out, first of all, there's no way in the hell the United States should be supporting Turkey in Syria. Because it is illegal for us to be there in the first place. There's no way in the world we're supposed to be supporting Saudi Arabia in their illegal war against Yemen that's causing 14 million people to starve to death. Right now as we speak, they already killed almost 80,000 people. Your government, under the guise of fighting terrorism, which is bullshit because I'm more afraid of the police here in America than I am some goat herders way over across the ocean, man. Come on, these people over here ain't even got running water and lights. How are they a threat to the United States when they can't even get a bicycle to ride halfway to the United States to call terrorism? Come on, man. Wake up and understand this shit is real simple, man. It's real simple. Your government is the biggest terrorist entity on the planet because they created ISIS. It was under Obama that ISIS was created. It was under Bush that this fake war on terrorism was started. And Trump is simply saying what he's really trying to do, and y'all better pay attention, He's trying to appease his voter base because he told his voters, his supporters, when he was running for office, that one of his main projects or one of his main goals in his administration was to quit the illegal wars. So now the deep state, when I say deep state, that means your surveillance community, FBI, CIA, NSA, and the rest of them alphabet boys, who are nothing more than whores for the military-industrial complex, they're mad at him for pulling out of Syria. Do y'all realize that the United States has dropped so many bombs in Syria, Yemen, Lebanon, Afghanistan over the last 15 years that we don't have that many more bombs? Yes, Obama, yes, Mr. Scroggins, Obama and Hillary created ISIS. Go back, man, and look at history. When you go back and look at what happened when they basically what happened, ISIS was created. Now, I'm going to go back. It was really Bush who created those groups of individual terrorists. Al-Nusra, ISIS, the Taliban. The Taliban actually was a group in itself that was basically in Afghanistan keeping their people basically in order. We don't care. I mean, I could care less whether they was using Sharia law or whatever, but they kept peace in that country. It was us, the United States, that came over and created destabilization when we started the war in Afghanistan. Now we got to go back to Benghazi to talk about ISIS. Do y'all know what Benghazi was all about? A lot of y'all forgot about it, but in Benghazi, you had Barack Obama, Hillary Clinton, and the United States government taking weapons that they got once they destroyed Libya. They took those weapons and funneled them to terrorist groups, namely ISIS. At that time, ISIS was just a bunch of militants and mercenaries who were willing to do anything for money. So your government under Obama organized them and gave them the weapons that they had in Libya. Benghazi is in Libya. They was giving them the weapons from Libya so they could take it to Syria and destabilize that country. This is research. Everything I'm telling you is facts, my brother. Obama, man, y'all sit up here chatting on Obama. Obama started three new wars, man. Four. Yemen, Syria, the Ukraine, plus he went back into Libya again. Y'all don't want to hear this as black people because y'all championing Obama when he was nothing more than a black face on a white agenda. How can I say that? Look what's happening in Freeport. You got a bunch of black face politicians who are supporting the same old white racist agenda, man. But y'all don't want to believe this because you're not hearing it on the news and a Negro like me is telling you this. But the truth is what it is. Bush, Obama started all the wars pretty much that we are in now. The last seven wars came under Bush and Obama. Do you realize we've been bombing Syria since 2014? Now, y'all didn't know that, did you? It was under Obama, through the military-industrial complex, that war in Syria actually illegally started. So I'm just being real. I'm sitting back looking at people in America like the biggest idiots on the planet because everybody is talking about, yeah, Trump is right. And other people say, yeah, no, Trump is wrong. But ain't nobody looking at the facts behind how that war started and all the tens of thousands of people that have been murdered, innocent people that have been murdered in Syria because our government illegally went over there and sponsored terrorism. This is a game, but it ain't no joke, man. Pay attention. Do your research. Stop listening and taking what they tell you on CBS Morning News or Good Morning America or Fox News Network. Stop taking that shit that they tell y'all at face value, man, and start researching. Because when you research it, you'll find we should have never been in Syria in the first place. And we are there now illegally. And it's highly fucking crazy that your president can sit up here and basically say that we're ending this war. Notice he ain't gonna tell you this illegal war and occupation of Syria, and then everybody fucking get mad. Y'all should be glad that there's millions of people who will not die because we are over there illegally occupying that country, taking that country's oil. Man, this shit, it's layers to the game. You know what I'm saying? It's layers to this, man. Craig Lee used to tell me that all the time. Rob, it's layers to this. And if you all just looking at the first piece of the puzzle, you'll never see the bigger picture because you only focused on one piece. We have no business in Syria, period. I challenge any one of you to show me where we have the legal right to be in Syria. I challenge anybody to show me what Donald Trump is legitimate in saying that we're pulling out of Syria when we should have never been there in the first place. Guess what? Just go back and look at the Real News Behind the News Facebook page and you'll see we've been telling you this shit for 5 years now. This ain't something we just come up with. We've been telling y'all this for 5 years. We should have never been in Syria. We're illegally occupying Syria. But most Christians won't say nothing because they're not even willing to acknowledge the fact that the Jews, those fake Jews over there, are illegally occupying Israel. You know why? Because the news is telling them something different than what I'm telling you. It wasn't Obama on why. Oh, no, it's all Obama. Dude, do you understand, Mr. Scroggins, that we would not have been in Syria if it was not for Obama? The Ukraine would not even be an issue if it was not for Obama and Joe Biden. Man, go back and do your research, my brother, and understand that Obama put us in Syria. It was under Obama that Hillary Clinton bragged that they went over there and murdered Gaddafi. I can show you the video where Hillary Clinton literally got on TV and said, "We came, we saw, and he died." Hillary Clinton and Obama killed Gaddafi and created those slave markets that you see in Libya right now. Everybody at one point, about a year and a half ago, was showing pictures on Facebook and social media about black people being sold openly in slave markets in Libya. That shit happened under Obama. Let's just face reality. Obama was nothing more than a black face on a white agenda, man. Come on, man, let's keep this shit real. We gotta keep it real. Just because he was a black dude, the first black president, don't mean shit when he continued to create three more new wars. Syria, Ukraine, plus Yemen. Research what's going on in Yemen. Look at the dates and when all this shit happened, you will find that it happened under Barack Obama. That's plain and simple fact and truth. Negroes don't wanna hear that. That is the truth though, man. Obama was just as worse. Do you realize Obama is one of the biggest mass murderers in history with all them drone strikes? Obama by himself gave approval for more more drone strikes than Bush and Clinton put together. That was 16 years under Bush and Clinton. You see what I'm saying? 16 years, Bush and Clinton maybe did 15,000 drone strikes. But Barack Obama in his 8 years did 25,000 drone strikes. And Donald Trump has done more drone strikes almost in 4 years than Obama had in eight. Man, we got to keep this shit real. I refuse to sit back, man, and allow my people to be deceived by this television. Because we simply refuse to do the research. And this is some shit I've been telling you. All you got to do is go back and look at my personal page or my Facebook page, The Real News Behind the News. And you will see, we've been talking about this shit ever since the war's been happening, man. We put you on game 7-8 years ago, and we still putting you on game today. Barack Obama started the war in Syria, Yemen. He created the coup d'etat. He even confessed to it when he told you he gave all that money to a bunch of, guess what? He gave money to a bunch of Nazis, neo-Nazis in Ukraine in order to overthrow the rightful president, rightfully elected president in the Ukraine. Negroes will never know this because Negroes don't do the research, because Negroes depend on that shiny bright TV to tell them everything, when the whole purpose of that TV is to control what you think. That's real game, man. But anyway, let me get up, man, and get ready for this job that I got going on. But hey, leave your comments, man. I welcome them. But if, when you leave your comments, I suggest that you go and do about 2 to 3 hours worth of research before you leave those comments, so that you will have a real understanding of what's really going on. Because I could tell anybody that's brainwashed right now just by the way they talk about Syria. Good morning, Mr. Cochran, how you doing? I can tell if you're brainwashed, because you're going to come out and you're going to sound just like them reporters on TV. And guess what? I used to work at a TV station. Let me say this before I go. Let me tell you what they do. Your local affiliates here, ABC, NBC, and CBS, every morning, they have a wire come down, and they have a video that comes down, and it tells them exactly what to say according to the video. And in the studios of your national broadcaster, ABC, CBS, NBC, Fox, and all that, they have military people, they have government people sitting in those news stations while those reporters are reporting, making sure that they tell you exactly what the government wants you to hear. This is a fact. You ever notice why you can look at Channel 3 news and they'll tell you, they'll say this thing about Syria. Then you go to Channel 12, they'll tell you the same exact thing. All the wording and everything on all your channels, even when it comes to Fox, MSNBC and all that. Notice everything that they saying is the same goddamn thing, word for word. You know why? Because they are being propagandized by your military industrial complex, by a government official to toe the line on a certain story in a certain way. This is why you can change all your news channels at one time and you're going to hear the same goddamn story. It's all propaganda, dog. We ain't got no business in Syria. Why are they talking about Syria now and ain't saying shit about Somalia? Do y'all realize that is the longest war we've been in up to date? We've been in Somalia for 28 years now. Been in Afghanistan for 18 years now. Been in Syria for 6 years now. And for 5 years, been bombing the shit out of Yemen using Saudi Arabia. But we sit up here as black folk thinking we so woke, conscious, and got all this knowledge when we really don't know a goddamn thing, because you're getting your information from a propaganda source. Hey, y'all be blessed, man.